think one of the most important things of being a Nigerian is the fact that you are resilient enough, you're determined, you want to face your challenges to the best of your ability. But at the same time, there's always this fear of the unknown. There's always this fear that the next, your neighbor is not good to you or is not true to you and all of that. Now, that's a different topic for another day. But the point is, when you look at how Nigerians have it, moved on in life, how they have, tried their best to be what they want to be, you just ask yourself, are we still the same country that we criticize so effortlessly and so determinedly? Yes, we are. Yes, we are. That's the truth. Yes, we are. Well, Mr. Ras is finally here. And my God, he's wearing... Oh my God, I can't believe what he's wearing. But he's wearing one kind of Indianish turban. Turban? With all the gray beard and everything. Ras, you still have energy in you?
I'm the jog on the staircase to come over, man.
Yeah,
but I'm sorry, I'm sorry. You know how Lagos is. You don't give time. When you give time, you don't...
Okay, we'll just take some advice and we'll get back to you, okay? All right?
Cabo.
Meet one of Nigeria's famous batik designer, painter, textile designer, art educator and gallery owner, Chief Nike Davis Okundaye. She is known for her colorful batik and paintings that offers a modernist gloss of traditional themes.
You know, Ras, I'm so tempted to let this music play, but we've played too much of your music. We want to hear very much of your voice now. And people want to talk to you on the phone. So this song, this particular song, Rastafarian,
yes,
when did you make it?
First of all, 1988.
1988?
Yes, sir.
Wow, it still sounding so fresh.
Oh. Well, that's the difference between analog and digital. if you listen to Bob Marley, that done 1970s or 80s, you think it's done this year. The weight and everything still sound solid, even more than digital.
Yeah.
So that's the difference between digital and analog.
Ras, you ruled the airwaves for almost 20 years and you disappeared.
Yes, sir.
Where did you go to?
Well, I went to foreign land to rejuvenate and reassess myself if I'm going to be in this game or play this music to the end of time. And, you know, when music is, when the ovation is loud, you step aside. But me, I'm a bridge in them. A lot of us who went to exile or foreign, left out of Nigerian economy there was not nosediving, dived into gully already. And we don't sell records, we don't play shows, we're not a party musicians, we are concert musicians. And if we can't play concert, we can't have no sales, how do we feed our family? So most of us tend to go and look for greener pasture. But unfortunately, some heed red pasture.
Wow.
You know, and when you go foreign, you have the good, the bad, and ugly. It's for you to choose. And a lot of members in them and friends choose the red pasture. And I choose green pasture. That's why I come back here to start up again.
Yeah.
Hitting greener pasture is not hitting there. But when you come back and come back alive and still strong,
yeah,
let me say, hit the greener pasture.
Yes, man.
Someone them go there and hit red pasture, they never come back, or they come back, they're tired, they never can do nothing. Because, say, in a foreign for. But my brother said, Mutabaruka, it's not good if you stay in a white man country too long. When you stay there, you start getting syphilis, diabetes, and now the East has end up with AIDS. So, you know, so we call foreign land, and the cold weather gives you a lot of illnesses and sicknesses.
You
know?
Ras, we're going to talk about reggae very strictly now. Mm-hmm. And I can't help but bring my brother into this.
Right.
You know, he was your colleague. He was very, very involved. And you had great respect for each other.
Right.
Me and my Jack Fashek.
Yeah, man.
You know, what happened to reggae? Do you think it has changed or is still alive or is transforming or what?
Well, reggae have gone out to national for a long time, boss.
Yeah.
Now, we not say international because when we say international means within Africans.
Yeah.
You know, out to national, reggae is in Switzerland, reggae is New Zealand, far places, Australia, yeah, Europe, America. Reggae gone out to national for a long time and no idiot boy can stop reggae music.
Mm.
It's unfortunately that down here, so in Nigeria, we don't have a recording company where you used to export, import, and, you know, change repertoires.
Yeah.
That's why it's like, oh, reggae is not really making them bad. But guess what? Those who love reggae music, listen to reggae music, because our Nigerian youth, most Nigerian youth now, they know about Movado. They know about Vibes Cartel. They know about little youth who come into reggae music now. So that means, Nigerian youths, by hook or by crook, there's a way they get reggae music and coming. But because we don't have a company that deals strictly with reggae, that's why it's like, oh, reggae hasn't got its balance. But I like that. And nowadays, your station, every other station, they play reggae music more than before. So that means, reggae still running. We're not about it. And like you say about my bridge, Magic. Yeah, we did a concert last October 1st. Me and him.
Really?
Yeah, I'm me, Magic.
Wow.
Harris Willicky, Righteous Man, Blackie,
wow.
Rhymeso, Maggie, Black Rasta from Ghana, you know? About 12 of us did a concert in Port Harcourt, you know? So we're there, and Magic is strong on stage still, you know? Even though, some man them say, it's not too looking good, but with time, it's a matter of time.
We're praying for him,
yeah,
you
man,
know?
He's going to recover fully, you know?
Well, Ras, why do you call yourself Ras?
Well,
I've asked that question 25 years ago.
Ras, you're supposed to be, you're Ras. Every black man is Ras. Ras in American word means head creator. So you're head of the family, you're head of the station. Me and Ras, every black man is Ras. So it's a title for every black man to bear. Like in Topia, you see, Ras McNeil, Ras Timbuktu, Ras. It's a tackle of everybody to be here.
Where is Kimono from?
From Ras Kimono is a Chuban African. Because my footprint or my footstep I follow is people like Kwame Nkrumah and Braille Selassie, Zico Franklin, Jomo Kenyatta. All the men, they will come together and form United States of America, Africa. But no, they find out that America is existing. They say, no, OAU, Organization of African Unity.
Yes.
So I demand them who say, Africa for African.
Yes.
And them support and believe in and respond to support Africa. It's not a privilege for me to be in Nigeria today. It's my right.
Yes, sir.
And if Nigeria don't want to obey the laws of Jaja with their force and fight, me go on Senegal. It's not a privilege, it's my right. But Senegal is in Africa. If Senegal go with madness, we go Ghana. If Ghana go with the illness, we go Togo. Anywhere, Africa.
You're an African,
brother. I'm an African.
Okay, guys, you want to call Ras Kimono? He's right here with you. Many of you called earlier. You said you wanted to speak with him. Here he is. Hello. You see, I just want to save time. Hello. Yes, hi. This is your phone today, not good. Wait till it happen. But try again.
Hello?
Is this Chris?
Yeah, this is Chris.
Okay, go ahead, ask your question. The phone is a bit funny.
It should not be offended.
No. Go ahead.
Yeah, my brother, bless.
My brother, you're welcome.
Give thanks, bros.
My daughter was asking me, you're Nigerian, I said, yes, you're from Delta. You're from Delta State.
Well, if data is in Africa, me Africa, you say so. Tell your data.
I just want that to know.
No. See, Bridget, see, we have to educate our youths. Because if I ask her about now, Christopher Columbus and Mungo Park and Mary Celeste, am I going to tell me about them? But unfortunately, we don't know about our culture. If I ask her about Zeke of Africa, she probably doesn't know anything about Zeke or Kwame Nkrumah. So we have to start letting our youth know, we are all one all this where you come from, that bring all these sorts of fights in our community.
So you like and unity?
Me not that, you know. It's oneness we are dealing with. Tell your daughter it's oneness. She's my sister, yeah? It's my daughter. It's my sister, she's my daughter. I love every black man, yeah?
Okay.
Yes. Under
pressure. Yeah. Remember when we played that music? We're going to play it, definitely.
You're not just an ordinary man.
See?
I think you see the future. What we are going on now, what we are going through now, my brother, what do you call that?
Well, what we're going through now is just, it's what I know we call a phase. In life, you have phases, you know? Sometimes you cry, sometimes you laugh, sometimes you mourn. So it's a phase we're going through. But with time, everything will be written still, you know?
Hello. Hi.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm happy and I'm very happy that you brought Ras Kimono to the studio.
Yes.
One of our legends.
Can you move away from your radio set? I think that's what's causing this.
Yes, I'll move away. I'll move away.
Okay, go ahead.
He's one of our legends. We are proud of him. I'm happy that he's speaking well and looking well.
Thank you, bro.
Some of us grew up listening to your Nasty GETTV and Under Pressure and things like that, you know. And they are evergreen. So please ask him, you know, keep it up. We would like you to drop an album very soon.
Definitely. Thank you, my brother. Give thanks.
I'm sure that it will sell if you drop an album because some of us are still, you're adding added followers.
All right.
Have a nice day, Ras Kimono.
Thanks so, my brother. I appreciate it, man.
Thank you so much. And there's a message from here. And this one says, Ras Kimono, welcome. So long. Don't know if Chief Sonny will, you know, invite the clock. For you. Oh, rewind the clock for you. Much respect meant. No disrespect meant. Okay. Emerson Colbert. Yes, I will rewind the clock. Don't worry. We've started doing that anyway. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Fine, thank you for
having me. Okay, I'm cool. What's your name?
Yeah, my name is I'm Pete from Tega.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes, sir.
How old is he?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Ras.
Well, I'm going to give you a mathematics now. Ras Kimono was born about 550 months ago. You don't know where I'm from?
Yes.
If you're a black man, original man, me a Chuman African.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you. You see, the thing about Ras Kimono is that when he hits the airwaves, everybody goes gaga, you know. And right now I'm seeing some gaga text from our special computer screen. It says, Ras, please, how and where is Sybil? I'm your fan. I watched you live at Enugu years back. God bless you. Tunji from Ikeja.
Oh, Tunji. Thanks, Regin. Well, see me there for my kids. They're in America now. No, right. Looking after the front line where I look after Africa, Zion, and make sure everything is set and couple here. That's why we're there.
And what about show gigs and all of that? How much of that are you doing these days?
Well, enough of it, but you know, Nigeria now is like, yeah, people say you're a legend and you're this and that, and we want you and come grace our shawl and tin and tin, and they don't want to pay you money. But they say you're a legend. Legend does not mean say you have money. They don't think that legend is hungry too. And some of them think say, because you're a Rasta man and reggae musician, who wear t-shirt and jeans, you don't need no money to survive. You can't ride a good car, you know? Them see me that way, man. I keep telling them that, no, we made the name already. Now, money me want deal with. Because I sing a song, give me a little sugar for me tea, me no want no cake. Right now, me want cake, because right now, me see there's a lot of cake is flowing in this country. You know?
Yes, hello. Somebody's shouting hello.
Hello.
How are you? Don't be annoyed.
Good afternoon.
Say again, please.
Good afternoon. My name is Chiki.
Chike, how are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
Kimono, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good afternoon, bro.
I'm fine. You are a legend.
Yeah.
You're a legend. You're a legend.
Just thanks.
Yeah. From what I'm saying, it really shows that you're not under pressure at all. Are you?
Well, I'm under pressure. As long as my next door neighbor is under pressure, I'm under pressure. As long as my bridge in them, in the countryside, get under pressure.
Yeah,
If one man is rich in a family, and you have a family of 24, one man is rich. Yeah. That man is not a rich man. It's a poor man.
He's under pressure.
Yeah. Under pressure, yeah. Big time.
Yeah.
So,
please, maybe I want to hear that song, under pressure.
You know, so as long as the masses are under pressure, trust me, I'm under pressure too.
I need to hear that song.
Where are you calling from? Ebutemeta. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you. That's Ras Kimono for you. And the number also free. Just be back. Buy your phone, buy a radio set, and let's get this thing going, cracking the right way, the Rasta way, the rubber styley way. Which is your favorite song, Ras?
Out of my tunes, I keep telling everyone who has to listen. As a track, I call Jar Guide.
Jar Guide.
Jar Guide. Jaja see them come, they ma vampire. Let's see where you know. Now they ma come, figo check here. So, oh Jaja guide I from the enemies. It's a prayerful tune, and it came out, it was my second album, 1990, was one album. And I did recorded 2002.
Okay.
And that album, it's called Jaga and I. It's my best track, one of my best albums. Every morning, sometimes it's like a prayer. I play it sometime in the night, I play it sometime in the morning, hello. You know, to guide and protect me from
hello.
All evil.
Yeah. Know? Hi, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good. If you're close to your radio, just move away from it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rastafari.
Rastafari.
It sounded like Rastafari. Okay. Yes, go ahead. Where are you calling from? What's your name?
My name is Matthew.
Go ahead, please.
Okay. So I was looking forward to hear about you.
Thank you.
You too much.
Thank you, my brother.
So I need to have your number.
All right, maybe off air. Yeah, when we're done, call back.
Ras is here, and he still has a few more minutes with us, and we're going to do some serious talking. There's one song, Arumba Styley. I keep saying this thing about rumba style. What is rumba first? Then a music beat, I mean.
Akusari.
Yes, sir.
To be honest with you, I don't know.
You don't know rumba?
I know rumba, because as a DJ, I used to play some calypso and some rumba music.
Yeah.
But at truth.com, I said rumba style. It's like a fill up of an album, of my first album. Uh-huh. But never knew it's going to be the one to hijack the rest of the charts. After I shot the video, everywhere I go, it's rumba style. And some man them say, Kimono, you can never do an album that we overshadow rumba style. But it was a fallacy. Because when I come out, Was Guan swept the whole
rumba out of the way.
Yeah, man. And I won double platinum award.
Yes.
From my company on Was Guan. Uh-huh. So that adage of people say, you cannot beat the first one. Trust me, I beat the first one hands down. I beat Rumba Star hands down. Then after that, I came with Under Pressure Part 2.
Mm.
Under Pressure Part 2 made more waves in East Africa. What are West African countries, even more than Nigeria. So with that still, I knock off rumba style. But people still love rumba style, you know? Because women, them, everybody say, Kimono, what did you do? But that should every woman and old people and love it. I said, give thanks still, you know?
Yes, sir. Want to know about your early years in music. You were a producer, weren't you?
Well, not a producer. I used to be a DJ still, you know.
DJ?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, you know, you look like a typical DJ anyway, with the Rastafari and your heavy beard and everything.
We used to keep a dance in Floating Buka. Floating Buka used to be a big boat in Marina, you know. So then we used to keep a dance. And I remember vividly too. I anchored a reggae program for about 2 quarters. Me and Uncle Tony Bebudem on R&T.
Yeah, may he still rest in peace. See, wow, see, that's true.
So after that, I went to Floating Buka and anchor, trying to promote reggae because I know I'm coming out soon, reggae music. So I got to have a base. So we're doing reggae dance until I came out. And it's like I've got a name for myself before I come out with an album. And before you know it, everything was everything.
But did you ever have a session with Majek Fashek?
Oh, yeah, you know, so because when they moved to Lagos, Justix, they are my bridge in them. So I was supposed to be part of Justix. Yeah. But I figured out that, no, I want to be a Lone Ranger. Hmm. So I said, no, let me stand alone. But as bridge in them, we always jam, we always play at the Kabambambo.
Yes.
Anytime they play, they invite me, Ras Kimono, come and do a tune or one or two tune. I do it, and you know, anywhere they go in concert, they come. Then if you had no goalie, yeah, if you have a concert, a Mogus invite me, I go with them. Mustafa, amigo, rest in peace. Mustafa had a band too, and anytime Mustafa's going on show, they call me. And as a flex and youth man, we used to have a band too in University of Ife with this actor, Yemi Remy, and the rest. This lecturer in the University of Lasso.
Lasso?
Yeah.
How was that again?
Okay. Refer me now. So we used to have a band in Unife called the Floaters.
Yeah.
So sometimes I do reggae tune with them, and Yemi Remy do High Life or do Fuji too. Different artists come and you know perform. So that's how.
I'm sure you miss all these things. The way music has evolved, how do you see it?
Well, I don't know if it's for good or for bad, because a lot of people are complaining. No content. But the music is evolving, because now there's a lot of money in our music, and the creators of the music, I give kudos to the producers nowadays.
Yeah.
It's not like our days, you have to think about bass line, drum, horns.
Everything is now computerized.
Yeah, so the producers work hard now. The producers sit in the house and work with computer, digital, play all the instruments, and just call, hey, yo boy, come and rap or come and sing, you know? So the singers them or rappers them don't have a lot of work to do. And unfortunately, for them, they don't want to even learn if tomorrow comes, because what's going on now, nothing lasts forever. And Nigeria is soja go, soja come. I tell you, boss, anything can happen tomorrow. And different brand of music will happen tomorrow. We've seen it already. But what I say, reggae can never be pushed away. Reggae have come a long while, a long time, and we're still there. Because sukus come here, and everybody jump in it and jump out. Makosa come, they jump in it. Gospel come, everybody want to play gospel. They jump in it, they jump out. Now it's new era. When reggae came here, a lot of people jump in our reggae music. But how many survived?
Okay. And now we're going to take a short message now.
Lagos, Nigeria, Nigeria, come here with Harida.
What are you doing there?
I want to play music.
Which one do you want to listen to?
Ras Kimono.
Thank you. of Rasta in the city. The man of Rasta in the reggae. The man of Rasta in the ghetto. Rasta man no deal with the hypocrites. Rasta man no deal with the hooligans. Rasta man no deal with the simple punk. I am I deal with truth and open. I am I righteous Rasta. Good God. Me coming with the message from Jah that I told you I must be free. I tell you Nigeria must be free. I tell you all Africa must be free. Them no love China man, just a poor African man them want. Say what? I just a poor African man them want. Them no love white man, them no love coolie man, them no love China man, just a poor African man them want. I just a poor African man them want. Good God. Bam 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 bam. Billy 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 bam bam. Hey. Say that Rasta man of them a want. A Rasta man of them a need, hey. A Rasta kimono they want. Say that Rasta kimono they need. Say that Rasta kimono they talk. Say that Rasta kimono they sing, hey. A Rasta kimono they come. I say me coming with the message from Jah that Nigeria must be free. I tell you, I thought I must be free. I tell you all Africa must be free.
Yes, we're going towards the twilight end of the program, and this is Ras Kimono, our special guest. He said to me, Uncle Soni, I'm going to make it. Come, Ras, why are you always calling me Uncle Soni, by the way? Which one you did?
Well, I don't know. Even though probably you'll be 1 year old, older than me. Or, but, you know, it's the from time, it's the respect that I have for you, the way we met, the way we
give me knuckles, man.
we come a long way. I call your wife my sister B. Yeah,
yeah, sister B.
B. Yeah, and so we stay. We come a long way. Hmm. I remember one time in London, she came into London when my wife went to have a baby in London, and she called Kimono. I said, yes, who's this? Sister B, where are you? I said, and they hit your side. They hit your side. I'm your son. They hit your. It's okay. Where are you? She no London more than me. I gave her address. I'm from Christian Jack. She called me.
She was there.
You know, so we come a long way, bro. So
right.
It doesn't matter. I call you Uncle Soni, Father Soni, Bro Soni, whoever I call you. You deserve it, though.
You're always welcome, my brother, because you've been
boss.
A great guy.
Thank you,
and looking at today, you see show business thriving, and as you said, you know, there's a lot of money in it now.
Right.
Where do you think is the future of the professional music?
Well, I think the professional music we have a lot of future, you know. Those that I feel pity for are these young youths, them who think it's just about drinks and smoke and, you know, bling bling thing, you know, because some of them, you talk to them, it's like, hey, you envy because you're not making much money, that's why. But come on, man, a lot of people have made money and come and gone. Mm. So definitely, it's their time to make money, but at the same time, do something to fall back. Mm-hmm. You don't say you save a whole heap of money in the bank or keep building houses. If you're a musician, it's not compulsory that everybody must be rich.
Mm.
There's some people that have been in music before I was born. And they're still in it, and they don't even have a car, but they love what they're doing,
yeah.
And they drive pleasure, and they drive contentment.
Mm.
So whatever you do, and you're contented with it, come on, man, that's what life is all about.
Yeah.
So if you're not, if you're chasing money because of money, I'm sorry. So definitely, the professionals, someday somehow.
Mm.
Will come back again, and nowadays they're recognizing professionals.
Yes,
recognize, because like all these young youths keep doing awards and they give professionals. Sometimes they give them 100,000 or pop with it,
yeah.
And it's something because
that's good.
Yeah, that's good because it showed that yeah they love what we've done.
Mm-hmm.
So never will it die. A professional will definitely be a professional. And we're saying to you them. Come along, be a professional too.
Mm.
So someday, somehow, they'll celebrate you too, you know?
Hard work is always celebrated, and you
most
have deaf. Represented hard work all your professional life, man.
Most deaf.
We still have about a few more minutes to go, and then now we're going to play that song that someone talked about when he called much earlier, Under Pressure.
After seeing all was one in Africa.
Chanting to you, chanting this, I want me not go chanting to her. Hey, hey, under pressure we well, under
Saying in the chorus there, Ajakumo.
Ajakumo is a language from one of my countryside from Ilaje. Mm-hmm. A lot of people say, hey, who know the tune? Say, are you from Ilaje? I say, yeah, Ilaje, South Africa. I'm an Ilaje boy too. It's a language, it's called Ajakumo. A lot of people don't really know the pronunciation, but it's called Ajakumo. You know, Aja is a whirlwind, right?
Yeah.
Whirlwind. So the song literally meaning is the world now is under pressure. We don't know where the wind's blowing our children to. Mm. Yeah. And the lyrics, this part of the song was given to me officially by one of my boss, Ben Tomoloju.
Yeah, Ben
Tomoloju. He composed this song with his group Kakaki.
Mm-hmm.
He has a group then called Kakaki.
Yes.
Right? So this is the song they use for some drama.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it matches what I was singing.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to him and said, Uncle Ben, I'd like to eat this truth. So I'm a virgin. Go on, officially, you know. Give me a note and say, do it. If you can do it better, do it. And after that, some friends come out and say, hey, Ras Kimono stole Ben Tomoloju's song and made it popular.
Wow.
But I look at them, I didn't bother making a mountain out of molehill.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that I got official
permission
to use it
by the same man they're accusing you of stealing his work.
So I don't bother. Since Uncle Ben Tomoloju, who really on this chorus line, Ajakumo, Ajakumo, Kuboye, Ajakumo, Kubo. But a lot of people don't know where the song comes from, though.
Mm.
It looks like coming from somewhere from foreign or something.
But you see, that's why you're on Inspiration Radio, because here we unravel.
Exactly.
We make you know things you didn't know about before.
Exactly.
Ras Kimono. He has refused to tell me his Nigerian conk name. Ras. Bikono, ogini be your original name.
Kimono.
Kimono.
Yeah, that was what's wrong with Ono.
Okay.
It's supposed to be M-U-N-U.
Since Ras Kimono.
So, for easy pronunciation, you change it to Kimono. It's M-U Kimono. What's wrong with Ono?
What's wrong with Ono?
Yeah, man.
So, and what's your first name? Henry?
They gave me some Babylon name, which I throw away. So, I'm not doing that name no more. Gave me some Babylon name when I was. Them said they baptized me and gave me some Babylon name. And for that, me say me not deal with that. I just keep Kimono, which my mom calls me all the time, and my last name. And my last name is official. Kimono is official, and that's why I use my national passport
okay.
and everything I do.
Mm.
And my last name, which is strictly for business.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know that. And the people don't have to know that.
Okay. Those who want to bribe me, come and bribe, but bribery is corruption, so I will not accept. All right, what's your last message?
My last message, keep listening to 92.3 FM Inspiration Radio, because you get a lot of inspirations here. And I beg on Nigerians, what we want now is peace and unity in our society. Some man them say, Nigerians will divide. But I beg no. We come a long way. We cannot divide at this time. It's oneness. Don't listen to the, should I say, the fussy, pre of what Nigeria going to meet tomorrow. What the prophets will say, what the prophets...
Professor of Doom or Professor of Christianity?
Well, prophets or whatever, of the Babylon, the white man. Because the white man want Nigeria to divide by all God selfish forbid. Interest. So I beg on all Nigerians, whether Christian, Muslim, Hindus, Jews, whatever you serve, we should live in peace. Over 100 years we'll be in existence, and we cannot fight to divide now. Don't listen to Babylon criticism, man. Because if Nigeria divide today, the whole world will divide. And there'll be, if Nigeria is in trouble today, there'll be Third World War. Believe you, because remember, Africa is center of the world, and Nigeria is the head of Africa.
And we're so, right there, in the middle.
And when Nigeria leads, every other one follow. So if there's trouble down here, sir, let me say, there's trouble all over the world. So I beg you, all Nigerians, I beg you, let's live in peace. Killing is not about our policy. I beg you, let's live in peace. Amen. That's what we pray for. And youths want to come music, do music like Ras Kimono, I beg you, leave drugs alone. Yeah. Drugs cannot help you. If Ras Kimono can attain this height without drugs, without smoke, without drink, you cannot swear do it. Number one musician in this world, Michael Jackson, don't do all these things. And he's the number one, what I did our life. And if I too can be here, you can do it without all them things. I will never touch them. So I beg you, youths, musicians, leave drugs alone. I beg you. And keep listening to the Inspiration Radio, where you get a lot of inspiration from. Yeah? I love nobody. Uncle Sonny, bro Sonny, and my brother Sonny, much respect you.
Yes, sir.
For always giving me the time and bringing me back to alive. Because I remember when I came back from America, first show I play, you put me on that show. Say,
the Nigerian Music Festival.
Yeah, man, that's Mono. You must be part of this show.
Yes.
And that was my very first show when I came back from America. Much respect you every time.
Thank you.
Inspiration crew, me love nobody. Me love no. Keep having faith and holy tithes.
Thank you, my brother.
Love the band.
And that's the great Ras Kimono ending Soni Irabor Live this afternoon. This is how we just say thank you for being with us. Here we go. This is the question he asked. And this is the one he said was bigger. Damn, which one was that again?
Was fun.
Ras Kimono. Well, I can understand what's going on, because GETTV is there Tuesday, every Tuesday 8 p.m. and Sunday 1 p.m. on Startimes. Yes, channel 129. Don't forget, Soni Irabor Live, GETTV, channel 129, 8 p.m. Tuesdays, 1 p.m. Sunday.
Please start one more time.